freestyle reigning. If you feel the need for speed, action, or drama, you'll find it here at the NRHA Futurity $20,000 added invitational freestyle sponsored by the Oklahoma City Convention and Visitors Bureau. We'll talk to the riders about their sources of inspiration.
Love the movies.
And costumes.
I'm almost positive, probably Amazon.
That's just ahead.
Coming up on Your Horse Inside and Out, sponsored by Behringer Ingelheim, we're gonna talk about colds, coughs, runny noses, and fevers at horse shows.
Hall of Fame member Rocky Dyer will have some tips on keeping the seasoned horse comfortable in the show pen. And we'll meet the newest member of the NRHA Hall of Fame, Snip O'Gunn, here on Horse of the West. Coverage of the NRHA Futurity Invitational Freestyle is generously sponsored by Cedar Ridge Stallion Station, producing champions from the pasture to the show pen.
The Western horse was a master of a hard world, pitted for centuries against half-wild bovines, ferocious predators, brutal weather, and the sheer size of the country they had to cover. Their descendants are still nimble, fast, and courageous, with a rock-solid disposition that makes them beloved the world over. In this next half hour, you'll see them in action here on Horse of the West.
Welcome to State Fair Park in Oklahoma City. On tap tonight, freestyle reigning. All the same judging standards, all the same maneuvers, but done in any order to music, in costume, and crowd response matters.
The regular competition is a blast to watch some of the most outstanding riders in the world come in here and compete. But then you get to the freestyle, and the personalities come through so strongly. The music, the costuming, the dressing up the horses, everything that they do with that. It's such a fun event. And to me, it's a way to introduce people that have never seen reining to the sport.
It's just a few weeks before Christmas, and NRHA Hall of Fame member Rocky Dyer is playing the jolly old elf. Rocky Dyer, who lives in Salem, New Jersey, is the dean of freestyle reining.
The very beginning. I won the first one, and probably the first five.
Rocky's wife handles the music and the costumes. He handles the fun of this event that he and most riders think is one of the best things going in the National Reining Horse Association.
The biggest value is the people from outside that don't know reining horses that will be here to watch this and maybe get new people in to the sport.
Because you don't have to understand it completely, you just know that it's fun.
Yes, yes.
It's kind of it entertains our crowd, so it's, with a little choreography and we can entertainment value and, combined with the reining maneuvers, it's really entertaining for people.
Rocky and High Hopes Farms Starlights and Diamonds earn a 220 from the judges. Debbie Mernon of Grass Valley, California is riding her 9-year-old mare Jack's Red Pine by NRHA $3 million sire Jack's Electric Spark. She says this mare is not bothered by much of anything. Costumes, smoke machines, pirates, sword fighting, she takes it all in stride. Debbie loves the Pirates of the Caribbean movies, but says she has another reason for doing this routine tonight.
I dedicated it to my husband. He just passed away from cancer. So he was with me when we went to and did this in Las Vegas, and my kids were there, and we had a wonderful time. This one, I dedicated it to him, and my friends all in the barn stepped up and took the places that my family did and who wasn't here. So it was a blast.
Debbie and Jack's Red Pine earn a 216.
It was good. It was the best part was having the friends out there helping me and watching them, and everybody had so much fun. preparing to do it was as much fun or more than actual freestyle. It was great fun for us all. So,
Sherry Schwarzenberger of Longmont, Colorado, and Barney Kurth's 12-year-old gelding Game Day Surprise by Hang Ten Surprise go for a more dramatic effect with her routine to the Canadian tenor's rendition of Hallelujah, part of it performed without a bridle.
It's just one of my favorite songs. It's kind of an iconic song, and it's a little slower, but this version's very dramatic, and it fits him really well because he's a kind of very stylish and dramatic looking horse, so it just kind of fits the whole thing. And I thought for this event, I've never actually performed here, so I kind of wanted to do one that was special, and that one is one of my favorite ones, so I thought I would be fun to do it here, and hopefully everybody enjoyed it.
Sherry takes the lead with a 2:22.
I'm happy. That was great for him. You know, I'm really happy. It's, you know, he's an old guy and he's really kind of had the year off because unfortunately Barney's been hurt. So he's just kind of hung out. When I got invited here, I asked if I could whip him out kind of his yearly retirement, and he just did it like a pro. So I'm really happy with it.
Rick Johnson of Ray, Colorado is wearing his sunglasses at night for his freestyle routine to the music of Top Gun.
Sun never goes down in Cool Town. So, yes.
You got your flight suit on.
Correct.
Tell me about where did you find a flight suit?
I'm almost positive, probably Amazon. Yeah, so it's got some patches. We ordered some patches and stuff. So my lovely wife takes care of that stuff for me.
Drake's riding a mare owned by Ernest Wick.
Her name's Little Joe's Lacey Lady. She's by Little Joe Cash. She's a five-year-old. She's a nice little mare, and I'm doing Top Gun. So it's a little bit of the start of the movie trailer and then goes into Danger Zone.
Drake and Maya will jet into second with a 2:20.5. Fred Wynn of Woodbridge, New Jersey is riding his seven-year-old mare Friday Night Sailing by Friday Night Shiner. Fred and his wife bring a little Spanish flair to Oklahoma City's State Fair Park.
The music is, I basically added all the music, and friends of mine basically edit for me, and I decide what part of what music gonna go into. So it take a lot of time because I match with each step of my horse Stellas. So I have a beautiful assistant, which happened to be my beautiful wife. And I think about, I need a dancer because I want to make it the best. So my wife was never a dancer. She's a school teacher. So she finally, and she never really into the horse. So she finally decided to help me out.
Fred Wynn and Friday Night Sailing earn a 2:19.5. So Sherry Schwarzenberger and Game Day Surprise are still in the lead with a 2:22, followed by Drake Johnson and Little Joe's Lacey Lady with a 2:20.5, and Rocky Dare is in third with a 2:20 on Starlights and Diamonds. When we come back, Jessica Keller brings back the Dukes of Hazzard and once again brings in a mule to steal the show. We'll be back with the conclusion of the NRHA Futurity Invitational Freestyle sponsored by the Oklahoma City Convention and Visitors Bureau. Don't write off. Coverage of the NRHA Futurity Invitational Freestyle is generously sponsored by Cedar Ridge Stallion Station, producing champions from the pasture to the show pen.
You're watching Horse of the West on RFD-TV, presented by the Oklahoma City Convention and Visitors Bureau.
Welcome back to Horse of the West. We're at State Fair Park in Oklahoma City for the $20,000 added NRHA Futurity Invitational Freestyle. The score to beat is the 2:22 of Sherry Schwarzenberger and Game Day Surprise. Jessica Keller of Sumner, Texas needed a chase car for her Dukes of Hazzard routine and talked fellow reiner Andrew Fox into being the driver. That meant taking his first spin on a mule.
Yesterday was the first time I'd rode a mule ever.
What do you think?
You know, I mean, short of being a little stiff in the chin, she was pretty cool.
I don't know what all she said she has points in, but I know she does the Western Pleasure and does the driving and the English, and she's a pretty good all-around mule.
Jessica and Smoking Ice by Gunner on Ice earn a 2:20 to tie Rocky Dare for third place. Emily Emerson of Longmont, Colorado has donned her duster to perform to the country song Every Storm Runs Out of Rain, and she's doing it without a bridle. Emily's riding Give Me Starbucks by NRHA $2 million sire Walla Walla Wiz. She says the 9-year-old mare owned by Kelly Rainford has her complete confidence.
She is so honest and so good-minded, especially in the show pen. She showed better
than she was warming up. But I just put all my faith in her and just kind of went with it. It is fun. It is fun to entertain the crowd. It is fun to come up with your own routines and get to ride these horses that we're blessed to get to ride every day and show that off.
Emily Emerson and Give Me Starbucks wow the crowd and the judges, earning a 2.23 and the lead. Australian Dan James, who's now based in Kentucky, is our final rider in the NRHA Futurity Invitational Freestyle. He brings a bit of his down-under tradition to the Oklahoma City event.
I've been kind of wanting to do this for a while, to plan something of course, you know, the Australiana type theme. So, you know, riding a horse called Vegemite and bringing the stock whips out and having a bit of fun with that. So, yeah, it's a tough event. This is by far, I think, one of the tougher freestyles to be competitive at.
The registered name of Dan James' horse is Don Magnum. He's by NRHA Hall of Fame member and $6 million sire, Magnum Chick Dream. They also get the crowd going, but can they top a 2.23? They are going to be close, within half a point, in fact, earning a 2.22.5, giving Dan James and Don Magnum the reserve championship and a check for $5,400. Emily Emerson and Kelly Rainford's Give Me Starbucks will earn the title of 2019 NRHA Futurity Freestyle Champions and a check for nearly $7,000. When we come back, NRHA Hall of Famer Rocky Dare will share a training secret for keeping your horse quiet in the show pen. Be right back. Thanks again to Cedar Ridge Stallion Station for generously sponsoring our coverage of the $20,000 added NRHA Futurity Invitational Freestyle.
Your Horse Inside and Out with Dr. Joe Carter, sponsored by Behringer Ingelheim.
Colds, fevers, runny nose, snotty noses, these are all things, coughs, that we see in horses that come to big events like the Reining Horse Futurity or the Cutting Futurity or the Snaffle Bit Futurity, where you know, these horses come to an environment, they're exposed to horses from all over the country that may be carrying different strains of various viruses. You know, and these horses will pick up little minor upper respiratory infections. One of the most common viruses that's responsible for that is rhinopneumonitis. The other one would be influenza. And so we feel like it's very important for you to pre-vaccinate and make sure these horses are vaccinated before they go to these major events where they're going to get exposed to horses from around the country, come to a big showground with 1,000 or more stalls. Even though these shows and the show management and facilities do a great job disinfecting, they can't eliminate every possible pathogen that might be out there. And so one of my tricks I want to share with you, and I want you to visit with your veterinarian, but one trick that I like to recommend as a horse show veterinarian that's at all these major events is to do a pre-vaccination a few weeks, 2 to 4 weeks prior to the event. It's called Rhino Flu Rhino is what I call it. And it's actually giving them a double dose of rhinopneumonitis vaccine, high antigenic mass vaccine, such as in this Calvenza or this Pneumobort, have lots of particles of antigen that's going to stimulate your horse's immune response along with the flu vaccine. I find this highly effective in reducing coughs, colds, fevers, runny noses, these types of things at horse shows. So anytime you have to want to visit with about your horse with your veterinarian, please do so about respiratory disease. And I'm Dr. Joe Carter with Your Horse Inside and Out.
Your Horse Inside and Out is sponsored by Behringer Ingelheim. Before making any decisions about your horse's health, be sure to contact your veterinarian.
From the Training Secrets Vault, Rocky Dare on keeping your horse quiet in the show pen.
I'm going to talk about some of the stuff I do to make a horse circle well and to keep them showing. One of the things I see people is when they're getting ready for a horse show, they come out here in the pen and they lope a perfect circle. And their horses get used to that. They know that where they're going to go and they're prepared for where they're going to go. I try to make my circles, I steer one all over the place, so they start paying attention to me more than think about where they're going. Because they learn where they're going in the pen. So if I go in the same spot all the time, then they're thinking about it. And I try to mix it up a little bit. So first I want to make sure they're steering really well. I'll steer one in a lot, ride straight, steer it in, ride straight, steer it in. So they're paying attention to me more than just thinking about where they're going. And if you lope that circle in that pen all the time, you want them to be a little confused about where they're going and paying attention to you more than just to thinking about where they're supposed to go. So I want them to think about me all the time, that I'm telling them to steer, not just where that circle is. If they're paying attention to me, then they're going to circle where they want to go, not where they're thinking about where they're supposed to go. Anytime I lose their attention, I'm just going to pick up and steer into that circle. Another thing I try to do a lot on my show horses, I try to ride them one-handed. We have to show one-handed, so you really want to get them ready one-handed. I will take two-handed and fix them if I really need to. If I need to put them up in the bridle and fix their body, what I try to go back to one here hand and get them steering off that neck rein really well. And then one of the other tricks I do for a horse that's showing a lot is they get to looking for lead changes. And I found that people tend to only pick up and steer for a lead change when they go through the middle. So what I'll do a lot is I'll come through the middle and just pick up on them and hold them like I'm going to set them up for a lead change. And then go drop and go on through the middle. After a while, they get to where they don't think about whether they're going to change leads or whether they're going to stay in that circle. So I'll just kind of pick them up, hold them, squeeze them, keep them straight, and then let them go. You just really want to make sure that the horse is paying attention to you all the time, not thinking about where he wants to go. And an older show horse, I could come out here and put my hand down and lope this circle all day long. But I'm not really teaching him anything. I'm just kind of going through the motions. But when you go to the show again, he knows when he's going to show. So you have to kind of mix it up a lot. I get one to really hold him, go through the middle. It takes that thinking that they're going to go the other way out. The other thing I like to do on one that I'm showing is, after I get them where they'll do that, I'll actually come to the middle and put my hand over like I'm going to go the other way and then pull them back. I want to take all that thought out of their mind that they're going to go the other way. I'll actually come here and act like I'm going to go the other way and pull them back. You can see right there, even though I was moving my hand over, she was still thinking about staying in that left circle. And the other thing I like to do with the show horses, I like to ride them a fair amount before I show. I don't do a lot of stop and a lot of turning, but I do a lot of circling and a lot of steering. Because I think if a horse is a little more mentally tired, they tend to show a lot better for me. But I do a lot of steering. And really steering off the neck rein. You don't just want to be steering off of a two-handed rein because you have to show one-handed, so you want them to be prepared one-handed. That's some of the tricks I use to get one to horse show and stay in their circles really well.
When we come back, we'll meet the newest equine member of the NRHA Hall of Fame. Thanks again to Cedar Ridge Stallion Station for generously sponsoring our coverage of the $20,000 added NRHA Futurity Invitational Freestyle. Welcome back to Horse of the West. Let's meet Reining's newest million-dollar mare and 2019 inductee into the NRHA Hall of Fame, Snip O'Gun. Snip O'Gun is a 1993 daughter of One Gun by Hall of Fame member Mr. Gunsmoke out of Miss Kim Olina by Doc Olina. She turned out to be an uber productive cross on Hilldale Farm's Hall of Fame stallion New Checks to Cash. From their very first foal, the two produced winner after winner for Hilldale, including Hot Smokin' Checks, earner of more than $186,000, Big Checks to Cash, NRHA Futurity and Derby Open Reserve Champion, and now a million-dollar sire, Snippo Checks, NRHA Futurity and Derby Open Finalist and an NRHA Leading Dam, Checks Master, earner of more than $100,000. By NRHA million-dollar sire Gunatrasha, there's Inferno 66, NRHA Futurity Reserve Champion, and earner of more than $226,000. Snip's last foal crop will show this year, including this foal brother to Inferno 66. And she had three finalists in the 2019 National Reining Breeders Classic Open, levels 2 and 3. With more than $934,000 in offspring earnings, Snip O'Gun is easily headed for million-dollar status. And with her own offspring now producing champions as well, her breeding legacy is assured, along with her place in the NRHA Hall of Fame. Find more Reining content on YouTube at Horse of the West, and don't forget to subscribe. Coming up in the weeks ahead, coverage of the Attaquan North American Affiliate Championship, NRCHA World's Greatest Horseman, and World's Greatest Youth Horseman. I'm Jennifer Reynolds. We'll see you then.